Jesus, make a joyful noise before the Lord. Amen. Happy, happy, happy anniversary to all. Amen. It's testimony time. It's testimony time. Your name and your testimony in 1 minute.
I greet you all in the name of Jesus. We're the Akonde family, and on the, what day was it? No, the 31st of January, late around 9 o'clock, I started having labor pains. I'm sure some of you have seen me in church with my big tummy. I started getting labor pains around 9 o'clock at night. Eventually, around 2 o'clock, I woke my husband up and told him we should go to the hospital. I was there for the whole night until morning. Still nothing was happening. Until around 10, I think, in the morning, the doctor decided that they're going to break the water because nothing was still happening. And then around 4, was it around 4?
Praise the Lord. See, she's just trying, but she can't remember. So after our perfect wedding, you know, ladies do that normally. They have to watch because she's feeling funny. So to cut a long story short, by the next morning, she's still in labor. So my phone was dead because I was panicking. I have to call mommy and daddy, tell her, mommy and daddy, this is what we're going through because I can't take it alone. You understand? I don't have a family here. Fine, I'm from Nigeria and all that. So I had to go charge my phone, then try and call mommy as around 3:30 because she was in 6 centimeters, I think. For a very long time, then mommy said, okay, you know what, I'll make you call, I'll tell daddy to call you. Then daddy called me around 4:08, because I was taking notes of the time. 4:08, then it was like, okay, put the phone on speaker, and put the phone on your wife's stomach. So there was this lady nurse that was there, she was about to make her own final diagnosis. So she was irritated, like, all this, why, over 19 hours, close to 20 hours, we've been here, 6 centimeters. Okay, you know what, when you are done, just let me know. She was irritated, she just left. Then daddy prayed for like 4 minutes. Then when she came back, I told her I'm done. She was even being snobbish, like, why are you wasting my time? 19 hours, so it's the prayer that will make the baby come down after 19 hours. So when she came, she just checked. She was like, it's 8 centimeters. I think she's getting closer. Because already, she wanted to make the final report before he tell the doctor to get the Caesar guy, because Caesar guy was coming on his way anyway, but there was traffic from Albertine. So the doctor came, was like, I already called the doctor for the CS because I don't have time. It's been a long time. So when the doctor came to confirm if it's 8 centimeters, then it's 10 centimeters. So before you know, then he was like, quickly, let's arrange. Before you know, 1, 2, you know, first push, baby came out half. Before the guy could say push, baby is out. And I was there. So I had to receive the baby because it's too fast. Then the lady was like, wow, I would like to meet your pastor. You must call your pastor. Then just when the baby came, the Caesarean guy just came. He just came, like, what happened? I don't know what happened. It was 6 centimeters, but less than 40 minutes, the baby is here. The baby was born 5:23 p.m. And our daddy was like, don't worry, you will call me before 6:30, before I start the service, or you will call me. You know, it even happened faster. It was within 40 minutes, the whole thing happened. You understand? Because my testimony is very long. I can't start talking one, but I'll make it very short. So when the baby was born, they say he's not breathing well. So they have this thing in his nose. So it was then, I didn't know that day. I left. Then my wife texts me. She texts me later at night. The baby is in the ICU. I'm like, I don't know what to do, man. Because imagine, I have to start calling pastors and all that. I disturb these people. They call me with their airtime. I don't even have airtime. I'm destabilized. I don't have a mother or father. And it's very hard. What they do is priceless. I don't know how I can pay them because they are like the father and the mother I never had, you know. And in a very, very far distance, it's easy. I can't even call them. You text them. I'm ashamed to always be the complainant. So she texts them. I'm sure mommy was asleep. 6 a.m., mommy called me. You know, she called and she prayed. Like, I just got your wife text. She said the baby's in the ICU and all that. I'm like, mama, I don't even know what to do. So God's so good. When it was 7 a.m., she just texted me back. You know what? The baby is out of the ICU. The baby is getting better. After mommy prayed. Okay, cool. I tell mommy again, you know what? The baby is saying is not breathing well. Mommy says, see, your baby will breathe well. Your baby will be fine. And the mother and the baby will be discharged. on the day due. Guys, when it was the day we were meant to be discharged, there were four delivery that day. Out of the four, two was CS, two was normal delivery. But one, the other one, the baby was fine, but the mother was not fine. But to God be the glory, 11 a.m., I drove this car on the highest speed with the baby mama and my child out of the hospital. I was so happy. So I'm just cutting this short. I can't really just say a lot of things. But to have people like Pastor, Mr. and Mrs. Tao in your life, man, you have everything. Because I know, I just don't know. Then the last but not the least, we daddy did not know. On the day of the baby dedication naming, so I was telling Pastor, Mommy, see, I don't have money. I don't even know what to do. Mommy was like, see, don't worry about entertainment. Just, even if it's water and all that, just do. Fine. My mother-in-law made scones and they bought juice. Cool. And daddy came and all that. They pray and, you know, take nice photos and all that. Then daddy did one thing that amazed me most after the prayer and all that. There is no, daddy dedicated a U.S. dollars. Listen, a U.S. dollars onto the baby's palm. Okay, I've not paid my rent. I don't have food, bro. I'm broke. It's normal. People get broke. Because of this now, they say you can't swipe Nigerian bank card. You can't swipe Nigerian bank card. You have a limit and all that. So I'm still waiting. Like, I have to wait till I can be able to swipe. The next morning, miraculously, someone from nowhere paid what they don't even owe me. And I was able to pay my rent, you know, pushing the trolley, food everywhere. You understand? So I'm overwhelmed. Like, is it this easy? Really? Does prayer work? Does miracle happen? Like, really, just yesterday and today. And it's from America, same dollars. I'm getting it in multiple. Oh, really? This money is a covenant money, and it is not meant to be changed. Because forever, I always keep that money, because it's the best gift ever I received from my child naming.
All the glory must be to the Lord. Please bring the baby. Is that how to appreciate God? Is that how to appreciate God? Sit it down.
No man on earth should give glory to himself, for the glory must be to the Lord.
At about 2 hours to the first of, the service, it was 1st of February, right? I said, you know, when lion roar, when a king pronounced, wherever the word of the king is, there is what? Power. I said to the mama, I said, give her the phone. She said, she can't talk. That's how critical how she was. Say critical. Working in the miraculous. I said, okay. Put the phone on the speaker and put it in a dark stomach. Say, the word is, I'm going for the service now. Before 7 p.m., when I'll be out of the service. Baby, hear the word of the Lord. Come forth. And there was a decree. There shall be no operation. At that time, the doctor for CS was on his way. And she was already booked for CS. Daddy, how many CS was operated?
Two.
So she was supposed to be number 3 CS. But the God of this commission roared and said, baby, come. And the baby came without operation. And even the doctor said, I want to know that your pastor. Before that time, they told her, you better call your pastor or your sangoma, anyone you are serving. And you know we serve God here. We are not serving fake God. Our God answered. The same way God answered her. Whatever the enemy, wherever the enemy is operating in your life,
amen,
I command your discharge,
amen,
this morning,
amen,
in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
So this is another altar in the house of the Lord. And we want to welcome altar in the altar of God. Our apostle is in the house. Can you just see the way they kneel down before the Lord? Not before me. They are just appreciating God. Do you know what? If this child was operated that day, that would have been the end. That's the truth. Because he was already in labor for how many hours? 20 hours. If she went into that labor, that would have been the end of the destiny. But you know what? This is an altar of the Lord. And the $10, how many $20, commanded America to open for you. Come on. Hallelujah. Our apostle, please make the anointing oil. Let this baby be dedicated.
Thank you, man. Father in heaven, we thank you for your faithfulness, which has again find expression, confirming your word, proving your faithfulness, confirming that you are a good God. Thank you for bringing this boy to life. Lord, I anoint him in the name of Jesus. You said, I have found David, my anointed. With my holy oil have I anointed him. Said, the enemy will not exact upon him, and the sons of wickedness shall not afflict him. You said, with him my hand shall be established, and then he will see his desire over his enemy. Father, this morning I ask that you will let him live in your presence. You will cause his horn to be exalted like the horn of a unicorn. You will cause your hand to be established in his life and through him in his generation. The enemy will not exact upon him. The sons of wickedness will not afflict him. He will be far from oppression and from terror and from wickedness. They will not come near him. From childhood, they will know the Holy Scripture. They will make him wise unto eternal life. He shall not be child of Belial. It's an altar for you. Lord, your presence will dwell continually in him, and it will dwell continually in your presence. The covenant of Abraham, the covenant of David, the covenant of the New Testament, Lord, they will find fulfillment on his life. The sure masses of David, the Abrahamic covenant blessing, and the covenant of the greater promise of the New Testament will be fully finding expression on daily basis and throughout the life of this child and his family, and the children shall come after him. Thank you, Father, for prospering your pleasure. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Hallelujah. Okay, one more thing. You heard the testimony the father said. The father said that the mommy has, or the baby has kept the dollar, and they want to tear it so that he can ask one, and then the mother can ask one. Okay, you see, testimony give birth to testimony. All right. So again, gate of nation is opening again. Amen. In the name of the Father, the Son. So we don't need to tear. Okay. It was America before. Now it is Europe. Now it is Europe. In the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The gate of Europe open for this family.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. As you are a witness to it, the gate of Europe open for you. Amen. Congratulations. Congratulations. Congratulations.